Hello everybody, this is Moshe, the Electric Israeli, and on a rainy Sunday, driving around with my Leaf, I just want to say, yesterday I went to my local Chevy dealership and I test drove the Chevy Bolt EV. You know, I posted two videos in this week about the Chevy Bolt versus the Model 3, and I did sit on... I was inside the Chevy Bolt at the auto show in New York. I did not see the Model 3, obviously. I did drive the Model S several times. So you know, a lot of discussions is really great. You guys are doing a great job with the discussions and all that. So I decided, you know, I'm just going to go and ask for a test drive. And I did. And of course, they're trying to sell me a car. Whatever, it doesn't matter. I have to tip my cap to GM and the Chevy Bolt. Just like my Volt with the V, which is a very nice car. It's a compact, you know, small, tiny sports car kind of a thing. Not the Chevy Bolt. The Chevy Bolt is reminding me of the Nissan Leaf that I'm driving. It's very tall, little mini wagon, very tall, very comfortable. The only thing there is the seats. The seats are tiny, tiny. So, so you know, it's okay. I mean, you'll get used to it. And I the car that I tested was a cloth seat, which was very comfortable. I do like cloth seats. But the ride was phenomenal. There's two things I can say. The acceleration is just spectacular. It's a rocket. It's like 6.5 seconds, 0 to 60. It's going to be Model 3 territory. So it's a very, very, very smooth, fast car, quiet, like, you know, you can't hear it. And the other thing, on the left side below the wheel, there is like a pedal there that you can slow the car down, just like I have in the Volt. But unlike the Volt, the regen pedal that you have underneath the left, your left hand, by the wheel, when you use it, the car stops completely. It's like a brake. You literally never have to use your brake. I did not use the brakes even one time. It is spectacular. Once you get used to it, you can slow the car gradually. You don't have to, you know, like stop it right away. You can, but it's really incredible. Your brake pads will last forever. Unlike the Volt, now I'm already comparing the two. Unlike the Volt, the visibility with the Volt is amazing, just like the Leaf. It's amazing visibility. You can really, it's like panoramic. You can see everything. It's fabulous. So it's really, 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 really good. I have to say, it's no question about it. I tip my cap. It's a great car. So By all means, if an electric car, long range is something that you need, and you don't want to wait for the Model 3 or the Nissan Leaf, 220 miles. That's coming in a year. It's not coming now. It's coming in a year. So the Chevy Bolt EV is available now. It's a great looking mini wagon. Great. Comfortable visibility, fast, and man, 240 miles. You can really, really, really use it 99.9% of the time. Now, I did also look at the CCS charging maps and in the Northeast where I am, and they're popping up. The only way to do it is really like to go and start testing them and mapping them for yourself to know where you can go. Like when I go with the Leaf, I know exactly where I go. And I know exactly where I can find functional, available charging. So once you have it, you can start taking a little trips and see, okay, this one works. Start mapping them up like I did with the Leaf. So it is very viable, absolutely viable and available. And great. Do I love everything about it? Of course, no car that you're going to buy, you're going to love everything about it. That's obvious. But definitely, it's worth a shot. Absolutely worth a shot. Okay, that's it. Thank you, everybody. Help me change the world, one electric car at a time. See you next time.